I'm Darla Castelli, Associate Professor and Director of Kinetic Kids Lab. The research that I do here at the University of Texas at Austin is associated with children's physical activity and the effects on cognitive health and brain health. In 1983, there actually was an initiative where they legislatively examined the rigor of schools. And schools were kind of given a failing grade, so to speak, that things like physical education were a frill and driver's education and character education weren't really necessary in school. And so in response to these federal reviews of education, there was an establishment of criteria. And so standardized testing began to emerge. Are our students being held accountable to those particular standards? And that's how we measure it. And it has evolved substantially from there, so much that we have some school children who are actually being tested 87 school days out of the 180-day school year. And so that's quite a bit of testing.
The trade-off of time that we see is the schools sacrificing time for physical activity so that they can invest more time in academics with an ultimate aim of improving standardized test scores. My name is John Bartholomew. I'm a professor in the Department of Kinesiology and Health Education. If we think about children's physical activity, they have the least control over that activity when you're in elementary schools. How you get to school is something that's determined by your parents. They drive you to school, or you walk to school, or you take your bike to school. That's going to be something that's determined by the parents and how you're going to get to school. Likewise, when you're in school, how much time do you have for recess? What do you do at PE? And even in the classroom, you spend most of your time seated at the desk. In fact, there's very nice data that suggests that the longest period of inactivity that children experience happens while they're in elementary school during that day.
Here at UT, primarily in the lab setting, we examine the effects of physical activity among emerging adults.
All right, good.
What we test among the UT students is really we come in and we do an immediate health screening. So it gives feedback to that particular individual on their health risk factors. Following that, we will have them do a series of cognitive tasks on a second day. And that second day includes, maybe identifying color words that are in a different color.
Red, blue, green.
Solving math problems as fast as possible, or what we call a card sort activity.
Identify which.
These all give us an estimation of the individual's cognitive performance, how fast they respond and how accurately they respond to some of the tasks that we give them.
So I'm gonna go ahead and start it.
We typically then put them through an acute bout of physical activity. Running on a treadmill or riding a bike, a single bout or a single dose of physical activity, and then we'll follow up with the cognitive testing and see how it impacts their performance, their reaction time, or their accuracy, and see if it improves or changes.
Uncle.
From that point, what we're actually discovering, or what we utilize the information for, is they actually respond much faster and more accurately to cognitive tasks. But think about it, in learning, that's really important, so that you can process information quickly. You can navigate novel information.
Good. You okay with incline?
Both Darla and I are interested in physical activity in children and its impact on academic performance. She's more interested in some of the physiological mediators to that and what happens physiologically within the body and how that is related to children's health and what they end up doing in school. I'm more interested in behavioral outcomes. And so how does physical activity impact children's ability to focus their attention and then the impact that that will then have on academic performance? Texas ICANN is the name of the project that I work on, and it is really a collaboration between myself and Dr. Esbel Jowers, who's my lab director, and she's been my partner in this the entire time that we've been working on it. And our goal is to find ways to increase children's activity and healthy eating. So it stands for Initiatives for Children's Activity and Nutrition. One of the challenges that we have is, given this emphasis in elementary schools on standardized testing and academics, how do you try to find a way to increase physical activity that doesn't cause that trade-off, that's not based on a reduction in academic time to achieve physical activity. And that's where we began and really developed the idea around physically active academic lessons in which teachers could achieve physical activity in their classroom while also going over academic lessons.
First one is rode. I rode my bike.
Some examples of what we do is we do something called spelling relay, and this is an example where the teacher will break the kids up into teams and give them a word to spell, and they'll run back and forth to either the chalkboard or they'll use a whiteboard, and each child will write one letter, run back, the second child adds a letter, and then the first team done wins. And it's really fun for the kids because they're going over what's relatively dry factual information about how to spell, but it makes it a really enjoyable, fun game to do. Another game that we do that would require a greater amount of space, where maybe you go outside, is a lesson that's built around front of the boat, back of the boat. And the idea is that one side of the boat is the front side, one side's the back side, and the children answer a question, and the question is related to one of those two sides.
If the answer is an odd number, you go to that light pole.
3 times 3 equals 9.
What we have now shown through a series of studies is that when you give children these sort of physically active academic breaks, when they come back, they have much better attentional focus and a much better control over their behavior in the time following that.